Welcome to the newest and innovative talk show, Ladies of Society, with your host, Queen, the Black Butterfly herself. Tune in to the hottest new show as Queen brings you the news from her queendom of controversy.
Hi, I'm Queen, and welcome to Ladies of Society. This is a special, special moment for me, and I'm glad you viewers are tuned in tonight to share that moment with me. We recently had a premiere viewing at the Social Lounge Club here in Columbus, Ohio, for Ladies of Society. And we did the premiere the same night that the talk show was actually launched. We had a very nice time, beautiful celebration. The place was just gorgeous and, of course, fabulous entertainment. A lot of people don't know this about me, but I actually do sing, and you get to see a little glimpse of that tonight in a special presentation of one of my biggest supporters, just saying thank you, just so showing them a little bit of appreciation. So I can't wait to share that segment, which is coming up, so make sure you don't go anywhere. But I wanted to give you a little bit of information on Ladies of Society and how it came about. It initially was a book that I had written, and it was just something that I wanted to bring women together in unification of color, of size, of race. It didn't matter. I wanted to be something positive and inspirational to women who have been through so much, whether it be domestic violence, cancer, sexual abuse, whatever the case may be. I wanted us to have a platform where we could just come together, lay down all our differences, all our opinions, and just come together in sisterhood and inspire each other and motivate each other. And that's what Ladies of Society is about. And I wanted to share that message, not just through a book, but on a bigger platform. And what bigger platform than, of course, a talk show? I wanted to not just incorporate women with the talk show, because I feel like men too, you know, it'd be nice for them to have a place to go and actually sit down and come together with women and actually have a talk show that they can view together and, you know, comment, open up a dialogue, and develop a stronger connection even. And I feel like Ladies of Society is about that. Its purpose is to not just bring inspirational stories, but awareness and fun and all of those great elements that you want to incorporate in a talk show. And we want to do that for our viewers. Like I said, it is not just my talk show, it is our talk show. And it's going to be a community talk show, both locally and worldwide. I want to be clear on something, because I did an interview a few months back. The interviewer told me something that I should do. And I always, before the interview, I let my interviewer know a little bit of information about me. They were making me aware of the fact that you should tell people that instead of it being something that you share behind the scenes. I want to share that with you guys today, because I feel like it's important in just getting to know me and who I am as a person and not just a talk show host. When I decided that I would take on that name that was given to me by some gentlemen who respected the fact of that I was a businesswoman, and they like what I do. But when I decided to take on that name and accept that name, I said, wow, that comes with some heavy, heavy baggage, just that name alone. And I said, well, what would that name mean to me personally? And what Queen means to me personally is, it's not a person in a position that's higher than others or that's better than others. To me, a queen is a woman who takes it upon herself to be of service to her community. A woman who takes the lower position so she can keep her community, her race, her tribe, whatever you want to call it, and she keeps them lifted up through helping, through encouraging, through inspiring, of any type of service that she needs to be in order to see her people evolve and to see them grow and to be that testimony and to be that inspirational story. And that's what being queen means to me. It's about lowering yourself to keep your people or your community or even society elevated to be in a better position. And that's what I want to be. I want to be an inspiration. I want to be a help. I want to be of service. And to me, it's being married to your purpose, and that is to be a positive force for the community. And that's what being queen means to me. It's not anything with being better than anybody or feeling like I'm above anyone. It has nothing to do with that. It's about the fact that I love being of service. I love being that spark of change. I want to be that inspiration through my testimony that you can set your eyes on any goal you want, and you can achieve it with hard work, with faith and believing. I never thought I would be sitting in this position with having my own talk show, and it has been one heck of a journey. I mean, hard work, blood, sweat, and tears, but it has been so completely worth it to be right here this Thursday at 7 p.m. with you guys, just bringing everything to the table, to the forefront, bring you something real and authentic in a talk show. And that's what I want to share with you guys. So I'm going to leave you with that while we take you to the clip of the premiere of Ladies of Society. I hope you enjoy this presentation, and we'll be right back with you.
You love me, it's special, like different.
Inside of me.
This show is being brought to you courtesy of Queen of Queens Productions, Modeling and Management. Let me give you a little bit of background information on Queen of Queens Productions, Modeling and Management, and what it is that we do exactly. We are a nonprofit organization that provides opportunities, training, artist development for individuals who would normally not be able to have these platforms and also afford them. We create show productions, mini movies, modeling training sessions, and more. That's just part of what we do to give back to the community. Welcome back to Ladies of Society, and I am so excited because this is a dear friend of mine who we have in the building today. The one and only People's DJ of Columbus, Ohio, DJ Frost. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Ladies of Society. I am so excited to have you here with us today.
All hail to the queen. All hail to the queen.
How are you doing?
Blessed by the best. I'm fabulous. How are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic, of course. Mm-hmm. Couldn't be no place better than right here on the set of Ladies of Society. So talk to me.
Man, listen. I just want to commend you again on the clip that we just seen you serenading your husband. That was like, whoa. That was like, it was powerful. I almost made an old man like me want to, you know, break out a couple of Kleenexes and get to cry a little bit. Like, wow, I didn't know you could sing for real. I didn't.
That's a little secret I keep, you know, hidden away. I used to perform a lot, whole lot, you know, and I do still like to sing, but walking in my purpose, doing what I do now is my passion, and every now and again, I like to whip a trick out of my bag.
Oh, all right, I see you fully loaded, fully loaded.
Yeah. So tell me, what do you have planned for this upcoming weekend, DJ Frost? You got to tell me what's going on. What's going on in the city, you know?
I'm trying to get some artists. I want to go out to City Hall and network with some people down there. Are you familiar with the Fam Jam?
Yes.
Okay. I would like to get some local artists to perform in Fam Jam this year.
Okay. Okay.
So I've been talking to artists and making sure their music is radio edited because it's going to be families there if we get the green light to do it. And it's just all about everybody's brand, putting your best foot forward and letting the other one drag behind.
Okay, well, give us a little bit of information on it because, you know, we want to make sure that we get people out there participating.
Fam Jam is what they call the mayor's party. Mm-hmm. And it used to be Mayor Michael Coleman. He used to do that. Now Mayor Ginther does it.
Okay.
And it's right behind COSI, right there where they rebuilt the waterfront, and it's called Genoa Park.
Okay.
So it'll be right there, and it's on a Saturday. I don't know the exact date that it's on, and it's free to the public. It starts at 10 and ends at 2.
Well, we definitely gonna get all that information out there and make sure that they know, you know, what day it's going to be on, the time, and, you know, I'll make sure that we get that information out there. Now, I know you know what is the hottest subjects going on out in the news, so you got to tell me, update me, DJ Frost, keep me updated.
Man, we're going to start off here with my man, Jesse from Empire. Now, he went out and said that some people beat him up and tried to attack him. And all right, the city of Chicago said, okay, you know, you made a boo-boo. We're going to let you go.
Right.
We're going to leave you alone. Why does this cat not have 21 seats and let it go? He wants to sue the city of Chicago.
Oh, wow.
You know, his ego didn't get all in the way that I got some get back. So now the FBI is saying they want to do a federal probe into the whole thing.
Oh, and you know what? Mm-hmm. He decided to sue them. They're like, oh, wait a minute. You know, we were letting you, you know, let this whole situation go. Mm-hmm. But you think that might have been what triggered them to pick this whole situation back up, is him not letting it go?
Yes. I fully do believe that. If you would have let it go and had, you have one behind, get you 21 seats and sit in it.
Wow.
First, I don't even know what made you want to come up with some type of story like that?
Well, allegedly, from what I do know, it was something pertaining to he wanted a bigger paycheck with television networks.
Wow.
So, you know, it's just a messy whole situation. It's unfortunate because that is a very excellent and heavily viewed show and mm-hmm. big platform. I'm not surprised because people do things for, you know, money, of course. But it's just sad because they used a lot of manpower to pursue it. But, you know, he's still sticking to the story that, you know, it's true. So, you know, I'm not sure. It's just messy.
Well, somehow some mess got out, some tea got spilled that it was all staged. And he paid for it.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's a real.
Well, we don't know any of the truth, so we're just
true.
Gonna say allegedly.
Allegedly.
Right. So we don't get in trouble
right.
with nobody.
Nobody. My whole thing is, you know, one, you should have been making two apologies. One to Empire because they dropped him like a bad habit. As soon as it broke, they, you know, hey, we're going to discontinue his character. I don't know what
Are
to tell
they?
You. Yeah, they dropped him like something on somebody's foot. Dropped him quick. Bow. We're done with that. So, you know.
Oh, my goodness.
You make your bed, you lie in it. My thing is, what is the community thinking about it? Thinking, because, you know, they got him Chicago got him out of jail. They paid his bond.
Wow.
So, you know, you owe a lot of people an apology. You refuse to sit down. You still keep on nipping at the cheese. This one here, Cardi B need to keep her mouth closed at some point in time. Some point in time. You don't tell people, when I was a stripper, I used to drug my clients and rape and rob them. So,
you know, I'm like,
why you do that?
You know, now I did hear about this. She is like one of the top stars right now. She made this comment, you know, before she was who she is now. And unfortunately, this is what I try to instill in, you know, the models and the artists and the actors that I deal with and help, that you have to be careful what you post on your pages, what videos you make. You have to be careful because it can come back later and be the very thing to be detrimental to your career. But what I want to know, do you think that it's a double standard for men who do it as opposed to women who do it?
I don't know, because I was thinking the same thing because of Bill Cosby. You mm-hmm. know, did they not put Bill Cosby in jail for the same thing? Asked this same question on my show. And a lot of people say that, oh, it was because Cardi B is a female and she's hot right now. Okay, a criminal is a criminal.
Mm-hmm.
And whether you just the average Joe or you somebody in high standards, one, you don't go around talking, running your mouth. Some
yeah.
things you take the night with you.
Well, you know, one of the things that they were saying is Bill Cosby basically said that he didn't do it and he denied it.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas they were saying Cardi B, she actually has it on video.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the difference in that factor, that they were saying that, you know, he denied it here. She's admitting that she did it. So why isn't anything being done? And of course, on Instagram, there is a woman who is really going in on her to mm-hmm. where she's even created the letters, where she wants her endorsements pulled, you know, all her sponsorships. So yeah, we definitely gonna continue to follow this story in the news, because I don't think this is the last that we've heard of, you know, the situation with Cardi B. But you know, we're going to continue to follow that story and, of course, bring it to you guys and keep you well informed. What's next on the agenda on Ladies of Society, DJ Frost?
Well, Queen, you got to let me introduce this next act. The three gentlemen, they ripped the runway at your premiere. And I know one of them for a long time, and they've just been doing the doggone thing. This time, he really showed out. He showed out, and he showed up and showed out for real. So,
yes, they did.
Man.
Well, why don't you introduce them to our viewers?
I want to introduce the video clip of the Harmony Boys. These cats are phenomenal, and they've done the thing, and just look at the clip. That's all I can tell you is look at the clip.
All right, viewers, check the clip out and we will be back with you.
Together, Columbus, Ohio, give them a warm welcome to the Harmony Boys!
Productions, modeling, and management. And we are back here on Ladies of Society, and that was the Harmony Boys here in Columbus, Ohio, a male trio dance group. And we will be actually bringing you a special presentation and have them back here live in the studio to perform just for you. Make sure you be on the lookout for those gentlemen, and we would have them in studio and bringing you their interview. They were on fire, right, DJ Frost?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. I mean, it was so fantastic just having not just the Harmony Boys, but you know, the young lady who sang, Taylor. Mm-hmm. We want to bring her on Ladies of Society so we can show our viewers her amazing voice. And just, of course, you know, the fashion presentation, we're going to be bringing that to you guys as well, just for you in a special presentation. But DJ Frost, guess who we have with us today in studio?
Queen, who you got, Queen? Who you got?
I'm trying to tell you.
Tell me who you got.
We on fire today.
Who you got?
We have model Simone Latrice, who is doing her thing in Columbus, ooh, Ohio. And we have special news, and we definitely want everyone to support her.
All right.
So welcome, model Simone Latrice, and her special announcement on the set of Ladies of Society, exclusive right here for you.
All right,
ready? Unfortunately, the time has run out, but be sure to tune in next week for the second half of this show with Queen and the Ladies of Society. Keep watching.
Show Ladies of Society, the talk show for women and the men who love us. Tune in every Thursday at 7 p.m. airing on Bounce TV 23 Columbus, courtesy of Queen of Queens Productions Modeling and Management.